Now, apparently the idea of Hillary Clinton running for president in 2016 is so daunting that Congresswoman Michelle Bachmann is looking for some help from a higher power.
Fast forwarding to 2016 for a minute, Michelle. Are you one of those who just assumes that Secretary Hillary Clinton will be coronated?
I don't at all, because I look at the story of David and Goliath. Mm-hmm. All David needed was one smooth stone to fell the giant. It wasn't the stone. It wasn't David. It was the strong right arm of a holy God. And again, I believe that it's in some ways up to us. If we repent, if we cry mm-hmm. out to God, we have no idea what the Lord God will do for us in 2016.
The good old cry out and repent strategy? Forget fundraise and embrace better policies? Let me tell you, this isn't the first time that Michelle Bachmann has taken the big guy upstairs to be on her side. You see, according to Michelle, God called on her to run for Congress. When she got there, God told Bachmann to introduce a constitutional amendment banning same-sex marriage in Minnesota. By the way, Minnesota recently became the 13th state to recognize same-sex marriages and end discrimination. According to Bachmann, God was going to perform a miracle to repeal Obamacare. 41 attempts by the House Republicans to repeal or defund Obamacare. Well, it has failed. God told Bachmann to run for higher office, and then God told her to retire. Still think God's a Republican? Joining me now for our rapid response panel, Stephanie Miller, host of The Stephanie Miller Show, and Mike Papantonio, host of the Ring of Fire radio show. I have to tell you, on a serious note, this is a gross misinterpretation of the Christian faith. Let's just get that out there. Now let's talk about Stephanie, how crazy she actually is to think this stuff.
Well, you know, Ed, I don't know if God's a Republican, but I know if God was a comedian, Michelle Bachmann would be president. That's for sure. you think back at just one of those campaign appearances, Ed. Just, hi, thanks for meeting me here at Plymouth Rock in South Carolina, which, of course, is where John Wayne Gacy killed Elvis on the toilet. Oh, it was just comedy gold the entire campaign.
But this plays to a commentary I think I gave several weeks ago, Mike, about phony Christians. They use their faith where they can, when they can, and they just throw it out there. I don't know, does she want to stone Hillary Clinton? I don't know what the message was in that soundbite.
One thing we can be sure of, Jesus did raise Lazarus from the dead, but it's not likely that he'd be able to raise Michelle Bachmann's stone-cold dead political career. There are way too many demons kicking around in there. Conservative Christians like these frauds that we see emerging from the fringe of the Republican Party, with leaders like Bachmann, they do huge damage to decency and to the simple, pure idea about how we ought to treat each other. It was simple. I mean, you know, if you really want to extrapolate what she's saying, if you're not Republican, God is not on your side.
Exactly.
If you don't agree with me, God is not on your side. What Jesus had to say was simple. Feed the hungry, take care of the ill, your neighbors who are sick. Don't judge your neighbors. Give shelter to the homeless. These are easy things to understand, and they've turned all that on their head to make it look in some way she really might believe, Ed, that she is talking to God, because most of the time she's just a little bit delusional.
Mike, you know what? I'm curious, because you're a lawyer, is I wonder if God had anything to do with the Ethics Committee investigating her presidential run. Do you think God had anything to do with that or no?
When you know the facts of that story, she's going to need a lot of prayer, I can assure you that. This is going to get real, real ugly before it's over.
Stephanie, why is this God told me strategy? It hasn't worked so well for Bachmann in the past. Why does she keep going there?
Well, and as we recall, the last president that said God wanted to be president was George Bush. And actually, if you counted the votes, God wanted Al Gore to be president, as it actually turned out. But, Ed, you know this. You're a sportsman. God is way too busy for politics. He cares more about who wins football games or Grammys.
Exactly. I don't know what happened last Sunday, but it did.
Yeah.
There are some people out there that are going to think that God is a Republican. I mean, some of these folks out there absolutely worship the words some of these lawmakers say. And I think that's why she keeps going there. But it's such a gross misinterpretation. I think it really has stained the Republican Party and the mainstream. Your thoughts, Mike?
Well, what happened with the Republican Southern strategy, the whole idea was to somehow make Southerners believe that the Republicans are the party of God. The Bible Belt was the same, was the place that Lee Atwater built his strength, Ed. And it hasn't really changed much since. There was a time where there's kind of been an ebb and flow of that, where you've had people with really a little bit of rational insight into what mixing politics and religion does to both politics and religion. They understand that if you have a political party that's associated with a religious party, as each one rises, it rises, but as each one falls, it falls as well. Lee Atwater thought he could drive a heart through the Democratic Party in the South by doing that. And you know what? He accomplished it, but the fringe is still spinning off, and Michelle Bachmann represents that fringe. And there is a kickback taking place somewhat, even in the South today.
I find it amazing, Stephanie, that she quotes a biblical story, David and Goliath, and equates it to Hillary Clinton. Your thoughts on that?
Yeah, they're very selective, aren't they, with their Bible quoting? I mean, the thing that Jesus talked most about, Ed, of course, was helping the poor, which is the thing the Republican Party is the least interested in of anything. They spend a lot of time, as you mentioned, on things that Jesus never said anything about, like homosexuality. I mean, it really is, it's incredible. They're very, very, it's like a Chinese menu, the way they pick and choose the Bible phrases, right?
All right, let's turn to Syria, if we can. How has the president handled this? Has he gained favor with the American people going to Congress? Just, Mike, the whole scenario that we've seen play out in recent days. Has this been a foreign policy upside for the president?
I don't think it has. I think Kerry's causing more harm to Obama than Obama's causing to himself. Kerry, his big words, his big action, his need to move so quickly during a time when Putin has set him up in a very, very smart kind of way. Putin set him up, and now he has Kerry reacting too quickly and trying to avoid diplomacy. That's what's coming through here. Kerry is just signaling we're not interested in further diplomacy. I think Kerry's doing him harm as this whole
really?
Serious story unfolds. Yes.
You don't think Kerry is really an honest broker looking for a diplomatic solution?
He may be. He's not doing it the right way, Ed. He is being outmaneuvered by the way Putin has set this entire thing up. It wasn't smart of Kerry to be on front and stage saying, we have to do this now. We have to do this immediately. We want your chemical weapons now. The truth is diplomacy is going to take more time. And I just think this whole rush to action is not helping Obama. I may be wrong, but I think as it plays itself out, I think we're going to see it was a mistake
Stephanie,
by Kerry.
Stephanie, how you see it? So,
I could not disagree more, Ed. I mean, to think that this kind of high-level diplomacy, it was, you know, there are a bunch of, you know, Mr. Magoos bumbling their way through it. Obviously, the president talked to Putin at the G20. He scheduled his press conference right after he talked to Putin. Interesting timing, right? I mean, do you really think this was some gaffe by John Kerry? I think the president has played this brilliantly, and I think that, you know, to pretend that they somehow at this level stumbled into this, if you've read what they've been doing on this for 2 years, I think it's ridiculous. And I love that Assad's making
right.
demands now, like he wants Israel to give up their nuclear weapons. Really? You think you're in a position? We have a template, Ed, for peace through strength. And guess where it was? In Iraq. That's why Saddam had no weapons of mass destruction, because it worked. They disarmed him through sanctions, through threat of military force back in 1991.
All right. We'll see how it plays out. Stephanie Miller, Mike Papantonio, great to have you on The Ed Show. Appreciate it so much.